Right. Sometimes you have a lot of data you're working with, and it just seems to stream and stream and stream. In this example, we have 1 through 100 printed to the screen. There are times when you may have a lot of data you're working with, but we really only want to capture, say, in this example, the last 5 data points. That's an example where circular arrays can be very beneficial. So circular arrays are just regular arrays, just written with a different algorithm. So with the circular array in this example, say we want to only capture the last 5 data points that are streaming through. You can envision the last 5 sales within the workplace, the last 5 heart rate data points that are pushed from your activity watch. Whatever it is, let's just say we want to capture the last 5 data points. Now, in this example, we'll use our for loop here that's just producing 1 through 100, and we'll see if we can stream this data through a circular array and just capture the last 5 points. Now, the idea in writing the algorithm for a circular array is to always keep track of the index that you're at any given time. So, for example, let's say we were going to push through our algorithm, a 1, a 2, a 3, 4, 5, 6, and a 7. Okay, so instead of working with 100 data points, we'll just work with these 7. And we pass this data through in this manner using a circular array. So, let's just change. So the 1 would be written to the 0th subscript, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. And since we only need to capture or output the last 5 elements, we're going to stay with this static 5-element array. And when this 6 needs to be written in, we're going to wrap around and we're going to overwrite this 1. Now the 6 lives there. 7 goes in the very next spot. So essentially, when we output this array, we will have 6, 7, 3, 4, 5. Now, thinking about the trick to writing this algorithm, the big thing is, as I said before, you just have to keep track of whatever your current index is, so wherever you're writing to at any given time. So you should have some variable named current index. Which is always initialized to whatever index is the next one to be written to. In this case, it would be subscript 2. So let's take a look at what that looks like in code. All right, so I just modified the for loop a little bit so that it'll work directly with the example we just went through. And you can see now we're only printing out 1 through 7. So I'm going to stay with my 5-element array. So I just created an array named last5nums and set it to have 5 elements, initializing to 0 to start off with. Now, first thing we want to make sure that we do is set up some variable, and I'm going to name it current index. I'm going to start it at 0 because, of course, our arrays begin with subscript 0 in C++. Now, within my for loop, I want to set last 5 nums, and then whatever the current index is. Remember, I started it off, the first iteration is going to be at 0. And I'm going to set that at whatever lives in I at the time. Again, I'm just using this for loop to stream a bunch of data through. Well, in this case, 1 through 7 within a 5-element circular array. So we can see how this data wraps around through, keeping track of only, in this case, the last 5 elements, which is all I need to keep track of. Now, During this first iteration and all of them continuing, I want to make sure to increment current index. Right, because we start at zero, and with each iteration, we're going to add one each time. And then finally, I want to make sure that, I don't care about outputting it anymore, if that current index, in this case, equals 5, I don't want to continue forward. I want to go ahead and set current index equal to 0. All right, then outside of that for loop, so we want to bottle this all up. So this is the body of my for loop. Notice, again, I'm just looping through so I can stream some data. I'm setting the subscript for the last 5 nums array equal to whatever the index is at the time, and then placing the data that's being streamed into that correlative element. I'm then incrementing current index so we can go to the next element in step. And since our array has only 5 elements in it, whenever that current index equals 5, which means I've gone out of bounds, I want to make sure and set current index back equal to 0 so we can start overriding those elements. And finally, what I'm going to do is just write a little for loop so that I can output that array so we can see that it works. Of course, since I'm outputting the array, I'm starting my loop at 0. And since I'm outputting 5 elements, I'm saying less than 5. And increment by 1 each time. And with each iteration, just output whatever lives in last 5 nums sub I. Go over here and compile. And then run. And you can see that 67345 is what's printed to the screen. Now, the reason for that, as we said before, is because that data is wrapping around in a circular motion. So if we take a look over at what we drew earlier as we went through the example, we can see that indeed what was output was 67345. So hopefully this gave you a good overview of circular arrays and how you can use an array to save a subset of data that's streaming through, and then of course save memory as well.